Boxing great Layman Brewster, in the history of boxing, if you can name three fighters that you never fought that you wish you fought, like in your era, like a Mike Tyson, you never fought him.
Nope.
Why not?
Because how do you fight your hero? That's the first question. I admired Mike. I studied Mike. I never got in a fight and never watched a Mike Tyson tape. I idolized Mike for what he did as a young man in the ring. So why would I want to fight the person that gave me the courage to get into the ring? I wouldn't do that.
Even if the money was there, even if it's not about the money?
Some things are better than money, man. Some things are greater than money, man.
But
you know, that's my hero. It's like Larry Holmes. He cried like a baby when he fought Muhammad Ali. So did Rocky Marciano when he fought Joe Louis. You know, I'm a softy, man. I'm not going to fight my hero. If I know I can go get money somewhere else, you know, why not do it?
What would happen if you and Iron Mike did get in there in your prime and his prime?
Well, you know what, man? I don't know, and I'm going to tell you why. Because it would never be a Layman Brewster if it wasn't for Mike. Because when I saw Mike, 18 years old, 19, 20 years old, having the courage to get in the ring with these grown men, these big men,
destroying them.
That gave me the courage. So I can't never say, because it would never be a Layman Brewster if it wasn't a Mike Tyson. I love that guy, man.
You have something in common with him?
Absolutely.
He loves pigeons, and you love dogs.
You know it. Yes, sir.
You also into pigeons, throwing them up?
Well, I'm from Indiana, man. They eat pigeons.
Stay away from Mike's house, then.
Yeah, stay away from Indiana, Mike. You had enough of Indiana, trust me. But anyway.
Who else did you not fight at that era? Okay, Tyson, because you looked up to him, he was your inspiration. But was there any other fighter back then that you wanted to fight but kind of just didn't happen?
Vitaly Klitschko would have been a good fight from the entertainment standpoint, man.
Since you beat his brother.
Well, yeah, but not just that, man. You know, I want to prove the point. The point that I want to prove is that a left hooker will beat a right-hander any single day. And I would have beat Vitaly had I had been able to fight him in my prime. Because, you know, a left hooker, the left hooks died out with the Bill Slaytons and Customados and greats like that, man. I can't even think of all the great trainers I really want to name, but there are a lot out there that really, if you look at the fighters, man, I mean, you go back and look at all the great fighters, they all had great left hooks. Now, what's a left hook? A left hook is it's not even, it ain't even a speech. You know, it ain't even a speech.
So, but I got to ask you this, Layman, though. Vladimir is what, 6'6", 6'7"?
Yeah.
6'8"? How were you able to knock him out when you're what, 6'3", 6'2"?
6'1.5".
6'1.5". Well, everybody else who gets in the ring with them now,
yeah,
even people as big as 6'5", just can't get close. Nobody can get
in. I'm about to explain it real quick. You know, I talk about martial arts a lot. You look at the cobra and you look at the mongoose. 9 times out of 10, the mongoose always beats the cobra, because when a mongoose fights the cobra, he gets himself, even though he's already shorter, he lowers himself, so it throws off the perception, the depth perception of the cobra, and he's moving, he's constantly moving, and it's like if you're fighting a tall guy and you constantly moving, and I'm low, he don't know how close I am to him. Only thing he's worried about is my power. But then when I get there on him, the only thing he could do is try to grab me, which is what most of them try to do. That's what you got. Good referees will make sure that don't happen. But if he don't, when you cut a tree down, what do you cut a tree down?
With an axe.
From the top or from the bottom? No, you cut it in the middle. And that's where I cut Vladimir Klitschko, Andrew Galata, Kali Mihan, and every other fighter I ever fought in my life, I cut him in the middle, man.
So if I'm the next fighter that's about to fight one of the Klitschkos, they need to call you or come to the West.
I don't know why they won't.
Fighting Connection.
I ain't right here,
West LA, because you did it.
I did it, man.
And you're still active and you're still a trainer.
Yes, sir.
They should have you in the corner saying, because you already did it. Well, why don't they do that?
Because their trainers have so much pride. Their trainers don't never want to say, oh, yeah, we asked them. Their trainers won't say, oh, I took him to the water. I told him how to drink. But you know what? Their trainers ain't never been in the ring against 6'7", 6'8" guys.